In calculation of median, you have learnt how to write the cumulative frequency, and that the cumulative frequency was of less than type. Similar to that, you can write more than type cumulative frequency. We can write more than type cumulative frequency. How to write more than type cumulative frequency? That we will see now through an example only directly. We will take exercise problem and then we will see how to write more than and less than type cumulative frequency. Write exercise 13.4. Question number 1. The following distribution gives the daily income of workers. Of a factory. Of a factory. You write this table. Daily income in rupees. The number of workers. Number of workers having daily income of rupees 100 to 120 is 12. 120 to 140 rupees is 14. Eight. One 60 to 180 is 6. 180 to 200 is 10. Convert the distribution above Today, in this one problem only, I will teach the three different ways of obtaining median using graph, and rest two problems I will give as homework. Okay. Convert the distribution above to A. Less than type cumulative frequency distribution second one more than type cumulative frequency distribution draw graph for each. Draw graph for each. Separately. Draw both graphs on one sheet. Obtain median from each graph. Write in box here graph of cumulative frequency versus class interval is called ogive, is called ogive. There are two types of ogive. One is less than Assume. Second one is more than assume. Right solution. Then write class interval. After that, frequency. Here you write less than CF, that means less than cumulative frequency, and then you write here more than cumulative frequency. More than cumulative frequency. In class interval, write all the given class intervals. Hundred to 120, 120 to 140, 140 to 160, 160 to 180. 180 to 200. Twelve, 14, 8, 6, and 10. Now we'll write less than type cumulative frequency. So you have to take less than 120. You have to take upper limit and write less than upper limit. Less than 120 means all these 12, you have already written such type of cumulative frequency. Here less than 140. That means 12 plus 14. Twenty-six. Less than 160. That means 26 plus 8. Thirty-four. Less than 180. 34 plus 6. 40. Less than 200 means 40 plus 10. 50. Next, more than. While calculating more than cumulative frequency, you have to take lower limit. More than 100 means sum of all these observations, because up to 200 you are having here frequency is given. So more than 100 means 12 plus 14 plus 8 plus 6 plus 10. Okay, so here twelve plus 14 plus 8 plus 6 plus 10, and definitely it will be equal to now 50. Next, you have to take 120. More than 120 means this 12 will be excluded. More than 120 means 12 will be excluded because 12 is for less than 120. So 50 minus 12, 14 plus 8 plus 6 plus 10, it is actually. That is nothing but 50 minus 12, and that you will be getting as 38. More than 140. More than 140 means now this 14 is to be excluded from this 38, or from 50, 12 and 14 both must be excluded. So 38 minus 14, it will become 24. Next, more than 160. From 24, you have to exclude 8. So 24 minus 8, it will be 16. From 180, to calculate above 180, you have to exclude all these above 10 in the frequency column. That means 16 minus 6, you have to calculate, that is equal to 10. And if you see here, above 180, you are having 10 only, that should match here. So now we have written here less than type cumulative frequency, more than type cumulative frequency. That means we have answered first two bits now. So this and this we have answered. Now to draw graph for both. Separately, take graph sheet. Along y-axis, you have to show cumulative frequency. Along x-axis, you have to show the upper limits of the class intervals. How many observations are there? Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. About 6 boxes you take. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now draw a horizontal line. Now show here upper limits. Upper limit is what for first class interval? It is 120. Here it is 140. 160, 180, then 200. Now take less than type cumulative frequency distribution. Up to 50 it is, right? So per division you can take 10 cumulative frequency. So 10 here, 20 here, 30 here, 40 here, and 50 here. Now for this upper limit of the first class interval, you have to take cumulative frequency as 12, as 12. Here it is 10, this is 12. See this graph book sheet here. This is y-axis, this is x-axis, and along this we have taken cumulative frequency. Which cumulative frequency? Less than cumulative frequency. To draw less than OZU, you have to take upper limits on x-axis. Upper limits. What to write? Upper limits. Now you show next cumulative frequency. For next upper limit, that is 140 as 26. 140 here. For this you have to show 26. This is 20 here. 25, and here it is 26. Next class intervals upper limit is 160. For 160, 34 you have to show. 30 here, 34 is here. Then for 180 you have to show 40, that is here. For 200 you have to show 50. Now you join all these points by hand, don't use scale. Like this. Now write scale here. X-axis, one centimeter equal to 120 rupees. rupees 120. Y-axis, 1 centimeter equal to 10 workers How many workers are there? 50 workers are there. Is it right? Total 50 workers are there. Now take this paper on which you have written frequency distribution table. Third answer, but to write here on graph sheet. Fourth will also be on graph sheet. Now you write here fifth. Half of number of workers half of number of workers n by 2 is equal to 50 by 2 that is equal to 25. Here what is this? Sigma Fi equal to n equal to 50. Sigma Fi equal to n equal to 50. Have you all written this? Now right here, to obtain median from less than OSU from CF equal to 25, draw a horizontal line, to intersect the graph. Graph of cumulative frequency versus class intervals is called OSU. If you take upper limits and draw, then it will be less than type OSU. Is it clear now? OSU means what? It is graph. It may be less than type or more than type. Right, good. Horizontal line to intersect the graph. Then from point of intersection, draw a vertical line to obtain median on x-axis. What you have shown here? Upper limits. So it is nothing but upper limits axis now. Upper limits axis. Have you completed? Let's now look at graph sheet. Take scale in your hand now. On cumulative frequency axis, 25 is here. From 25, you draw a line. To cut graph, at this point, then from there, you draw a vertical line. To get the median value, to 140, you are having here 20 rupees. You are having 20 rupees. In 20 rupees, you have to make 10 parts. And of that, you have to take 9 parts. In 20 rupees, you have to make 10 parts, and of that, you have to take 9 parts. That is nothing but 18 rupees. 120 plus 18 will become 138 rupees. 138 rupees. So, what is the median now? Median equal to 138 rupees. Very good. Now on this sheet you write from graph. Or in bracket you write less than ozu, less than ozu, median is equal to rupees 138. There may be slight mismatch between the answers of 1 or 2 rupees. Because it is graphical method, you need not worry much. So to this you can call as less than assume. Less than assume. What is on y-axis here? On y-axis, we have number of workers right here. Number of workers. Right here, number of workers. After that, here on x-axis you write upper limits in rupees. Upper limits in rupees. Now we will draw more than assume, more than assume. For that you will have to take lower limits on x-axis. Y-axis remains same. Y-axis remains the same. So here only I will show it. Please see here so that you will understand where the line is. One, two, three, four, five, six. Six boxes to take. Here about 5 boxes enough. Here we have taken 6 boxes. Here we have taken 5 boxes. Now you have to write here lower limits. These are in rupees. And here number of workers. Ten, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Here you take 100. Then you take 120. One forty. 160. 180. You have to write scale, we'll write it afterwards. Now look at more than CF. For lower limit 100, more than CF is 50. Mark it. For more than 120, we are having 38 as CF. Like that, you plot all the points on the graph. Fifty is here. For 100, you have to show 50. Next, for 120, you have to show 38. This is 38. For 140, you have to show 24. For 160, you have to show 16. And for 180, you have to show 10. Now join all these points by hand. Don't use scale. Again, repeat the procedure. From 25 on y-axis, you draw a horizontal line using scale. And from the point of intersection, positive with the line you have drawn, you draw a vertical line. Where that vertical line intersects, where that vertical line intersects, that is nothing but median. With what it intersects? It intersects with excess of lower limits. On excess of lower limits, we will be getting median. And median is once again equal to rupees 138. Very good. No problem. 138, 139, 137. Okay. Because some students may be having eyesight problem like me. Your pencil thickness also matters on graph sheet. Now write here scale. X-axis 1 centimeter equal to 20 only here. Here also you have to correct it. Because here it is 20, 40, 60, 80, no? The scale is, you just make it 0. 0 to 0 means 20 only. Scale for this problem is what? Problem number 1. X-axis 1 centimeter equal to rupees 20, y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 10 workers. Similarly here also, x-axis 1 centimeter equal to rupees 20, y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 10 workers. Because we are not starting from 0 here, now we will show the kink here. Kink means your graph is folded. Here also you can show the kink like this. It looks like small ECG signal. So kink here you mark, and here also you mark the kink. On this ruling sheet you write from graph that is more than ogive, median equal to rupees 138. See, both answers are same. And for this graph on graph sheet you write what you have to write here. More than ogive. More than ogive. Previously we have written less than ogive. Now we have to write more than ogive. Next we will draw both ogives on same graph and then see how to find the median. I am making use of same graph sheet, first graph, second graph. Now I will draw here third graph. You can also do that if you wish to do. Again, six lines we want. One, two, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And here also you show about 6 lines. Now you can write here cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency. Here also on this axis you write in the previous problem cumulative frequency. You write class intervals continuously here now. What you have to do, you have to write class intervals continuously. Hundred, 120, 140, 160, 180, and 200. All you write here. And here once again you show kink. Number of workers here as a cumulative frequency 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Scale you write here. X-axis. 1 centimeter equal to rupees 20. Y-axis. 1 centimeter equal to 10 workers. 1 centimeter equal to 10 workers. Now draw both osseous, less than and more than osseous. First we will go for less than osseous. For 120 it is 12. For 140 it is, I'm having that table. Yes. 26. For 120 you mark 12. For 140 you mark 26. For 160, you mark 34. For 180, you mark 40. For 200 it is 50. Now join all these points. Join all these points. Next, for this is what? Less than osseous it is. Less than osseous. Similarly, you have to draw more than osseous. For 100, it is 50. For 120, it is 38. For 140, it is 24. 24 is here. For 160, it is 16. 15 plus 1, 16 here. For 180, it is 10 here. Now once again join all these points. By free hand. Now these two graphs intersect at a point. From that point of intersection, here you draw a vertical line. Now this is median. and that is equal to rupees once again. This is median, and at this point you will get rupees 138. Therefore, median is equal to rupees 138. So based on this, can you solve remaining two problems from your exercise? Okay. Now you write here. From graph of more than and less than assume, median is equal to rupees 138. Median is equal to rupees 138.